Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video we will see the maximum power transfer theorem for the AC circuits. So in the last video we had seen the maximum power transfer theorem for the DC circuits. So let's quickly revise what we had seen in the last video. So we had seen that the maximum power will get transferred from the source to the load when the value of this load resistance is equal to the series internal resistance of this voltage source. Or if this load resistance is connected to the DC circuit, then this DC circuit can be converted into the equivalent Thevenin's voltage source in series with the Thevenin's equivalent resistance. And maximum power will get transferred to the load when the value of this load resistance is equal to the Thevenin's equivalent resistance RTH. And the power P which is delivered to the load can be given as I square into RL, where I is the current that is flowing through this load resistance RL, that is equal to V divided by 2RL whole square into RL. So the maximum power transferred to the load can be given as V square divided by 4 into RL. And the same amount of power will get delivered across this Thevenin's equivalent resistance, that is V square divided by 4 into RTH. So in terms of the efficiency, only 50% of power gets delivered to this load, as half of the power gets dissipated across this Thevenin's equivalent resistance. And this efficiency is nothing but the output power across the load divided by the total power. So the power across the load resistance is nothing but I square into RL. And total power is 2 into I square into RL. It's the same amount of power gets dissipated across this Thevenin's equivalent resistance. So we will get only 50% of efficiency. So this maximum power transfer theorem is not used in applications where efficiency is a more concern, like in a case of a power systems where efficiency is a more concern than the output power. But in cases where efficiency is not a concern and output power is a concern, then in such applications like audio system or in case of a radio transmission system or in communication systems, this maximum power transfer theorem is used. So now let us see the maximum power transfer theorem for the AC circuits. So for the AC circuit, the DC voltage source will get replaced by the AC source and the series internal resistance will get replaced by the series impedance. So apart from the resistive part, now we will also have a reactive part. Similarly, the load resistance will get replaced by the load impedance and it will have a resistive part as well as the reactive part. So now if this load impedance is connected to some AC circuit, then the equivalent circuit will have a Thevenin's equivalent voltage source VTH in series with a Thevenin's equivalent impedance, that is a ZTH, and it can be given as RTH plus J into XTH. Now there are different cases possible for this load impedance. So let's see all the different cases and find out the value of this load impedance which gives us the maximum power transfer across this load impedance. So in the first case, let's say this RL and XL both are variable. So for the maximum power transform across this load, the value of RL should be is equal to RTH and the value of XL should be is equal to minus XTH. So for the maximum power transfer, the value of this load impedance should be RTH minus J into XTH. That is nothing but a complex conjugate of the Thevenin's equivalent impedance. So in a case where both RL and XL are variable, in that case the value of load impedance should be is equal to complex conjugate of the Thevenin's equivalent impedance. So now let us see the second case. So in the second case, load resistance RL is fixed but this reactive part XL is a variable. So let us find out the value of this XL which gives us the maximum power across this load impedance. So for the maximum power transfer, the value of XL should be is equal to minus XTH. So we will get impedance ZL as RL minus J into XTH. So now let us see the third case. In the third case, this reactive part is fixed, that is XL is fixed, and this resistive part RL is a variable. So for the maximum power transfer, the value of RL should be is equal to under root RTH square plus XL plus XTH whole square. So this value of RL ensures that the maximum power will get transferred across this load. So now let us see the fourth case. In the fourth case, the load is purely resistive. That means the reactive part is totally zero. So in that case, for the maximum power transfer, the value of load resistance should be is equal to mod of Thevenin's equivalent impedance, that is under root RTH square plus XTH square. So this is the summary of a four different cases and value of a load impedance, which gives us the maximum power across the load. So now for the case one, where both RL and XL are variable, let us derive the expression for this load impedance, which gives us the maximum power. So for the remaining three cases, I will give a separate note in the description very soon. So now let us derive the expression for the first case. So let us say the current IL is flowing through this circuit. So the current IL can be given as VTH divided by ZTH plus ZL. So this IL can be written as VTH divided by RTH plus RL plus J into XTH plus XL. So the mod of IL can be given as mod of VTH divided by under root RTH plus RL whole square plus XTH plus XL whole square. So now the power that is dissipated across this load can be given as P is equal to I square into RL, that is VTH square into RL divided by RTH plus RL square plus XTH plus XL square. So now if you see here, we have total two variables, XL and RL. So first of all, let's assume that the RL is fixed and let's find out the value of XL, which gives us the maximum power. So if you see this expression, we will get a maximum power when the value of XL is equal to the minus XTH. So when the value of XL is equal to the minus XTH, at that time the denominator will be minimum and the power P will be the maximum. So when XL is equal to minus XTH, then power P can be given as VTH square into RL divided by RTH plus RL whole square. So now let us find the value of this RL, which gives us the maximum power P. So for that, let's differentiate this equation with respect to load resistance RL and equate that with a zero. So when we differentiate this equation with respect to RL, then we will get this expression. And if we equate this equation with respect to zero and simplify it, then we will get value of RL that is equal to the RTH. So in this way, we got value of RL that is equal to the RTH and value of XL that is equal to the minus XTH for the maximum power transfer. And hence, we will get a value of load impedance ZL as a RL plus J into XL, that is RTH minus J into XTH, which is nothing but a complex conjugate of the Thevenin's equivalent impedance. Similarly, we can derive an expression for the remaining three cases. So I will provide a separate note for in a description very soon. So now let us see some example based on this maximum power transfer for the AC circuits. So in the first example, we have been asked to find the value of this RS, which results a maximum power transfer across this load resistance RL. And we have been given that we can vary this value of RS from 2 ohm to the 50 ohm. So in this example, we have been asked to find the value of this RS, which gives us the maximum power across this load resistance RL. So as you can see here, the load resistance RL is of a fixed value. So in cases where the value of the load resistance is fixed, we cannot apply this maximum power transfer theorem. So in such cases, if we want maximum power across this load resistance RL, value of the RS should be as low as possible. So the minimum value of RS will ensure that we will get a maximum power across this load resistance RL. So for that, the value of RS should be is equal to 2 ohm. As we had given that we can vary the value of RS from 2 ohm to the 50 ohm. So the value of RS will be 2 ohm. So now let us find out the maximum power which get delivered across this load resistance RL. So let us say the current I is flowing through this circuit. So this current I can be given as ES divided by 2 plus J5 plus 10 ohm. That is equal to 100 divided by 12 plus J5. So the mod of I can be given as 100 divided by 12 square plus 5 square, that is 100 divided by 13. So we'll get value of mod I approximately as a 7.7 ampere. So the power P across this load resistance RL can be given as I square into RL, that is 7.7 square into 10 ohm. The approximate value of this power will come out as a 593 watt. So now let us see the second example based on this maximum power transfer theorem. So in this example, we have been asked to find the value of this load resistance RL, which gives us the maximum power across this load resistance RL. And also we have been asked to find the value of a maximum power which gets delivered across this load resistance RL. So first of all, let's simplify this circuit. So let's remove this load and find out the equivalent Thevenin's voltage source and equivalent Thevenin's impedance for the given circuit. So if we remove the load, then the equivalent circuit will look like this. So the voltage across this node is a VTH. So let's apply a KCL at this node and find the value of this VTH. So applying KCL at this node, we can write VTH minus 110 divided by 6 plus J8 plus VTH minus 90 divided by 6 plus J8 is equal to 0. So if we simplify it, then we'll get 2 VTH is equal to 200. And hence the value of VTH will be 100. Similarly, now let's find out the Thevenin's equivalent impedance for the given circuit. Before that, let's remove this load and short all the voltage sources in the given circuit. So the equivalent circuit will look like this. So now if you see here, these two impedances are in a parallel, and as the value of the both the impedances are same, so the value of Thevenin's equivalent impedance will be 3 plus J4. So in this way, we found the value of a Thevenin's equivalent impedance as a 3 plus J4. And earlier we had find the value of VTH as a 100. So now the equivalent circuit will look like this. So circuit will have a Thevenin's equivalent voltage source in series with a Thevenin's equivalent impedance. So now if you see here, the load is a purely resistive load. And for the purely resistive load, the value of RL for the maximum power transfer should be is equal to the mod of ZTH, that is 3 square plus 4 square. So the value of RL for the maximum power transfer will come out as a 5 ohm. So now let us find out the maximum power which gets delivered across this load resistance RL. So let us say the current I is flowing through this circuit. So the current I can be given as 100 divided by 3 plus J4 plus 5 ohm. That is 100 divided by 8 plus J4. So the mod of I will be given as 100 divided by 8 square plus 4 square. That is 11.18 ampere. And the power P that is delivered across this 5 ohm load can be given as I square into RL. That is 11.18 square into 5 ohm. So the approximate value of this power P will come out as a 625 watt. So I hope in this video you understood how to find the value of a load impedance which gives us the maximum power across the load for the different cases. So if you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.